And they're away. And Bragorn has jumped. Bragorn has jumped off with the others. Observe over on the far side. Brown Chamberlain, Bragorn, Foxborough on the near side. Burrahill there just behind them. And Brown Chamberlain landed in the lead there. From Bragorn, Foxborough, $50 more on the far side with Observe, and then Burrahill, Laddon, Scott Lane and Everett as they jump the second, and all safely over it with Royal Bond just the back marker. And Brown Chamberlain and $50 more, two stable companions making it. From Scott Lane and Observe, and then Bragorn, and on the outside of Bragorn is Foxborough. Then comes Burrahill Lad, and on the outside of Burrahill Lad is Everett. Behind Everett is Wayward Lad, then Canny Danny, Drumlagan and Royal Bond. $50 more on the inside of Brown Chamberlain. Very close to the lead is the third team member, Observe. Then Scott Lane, Foxborough on the outer. Bragorn, Burrahill Lad, Canny Danny, Drumlagan and Everett, Wayward Lad and Royal Bond as they run down to the water for the first time. $50 more on the inside as we see them. Brown Chamberlain and Foxborough, a little between the trio, and Bragorn very close to them, and then Observe, then Burrahill Lad, and Scott Lane and Everett as they come to the first of the four ditches. Foxborough on the outside, and Brown Chamberlain in the center, and $50 more on the near side. Plain fence this time. Brown Chamberlain, $50 more, and Foxborough. Very little between the trio. Bragorn is right up with them too as they race towards another ditch. Brown Chamberlain, $50 more, and Bragorn. Then Burrahill Lad and Foxborough. Then Observe and Scott Lane and Canny Danny and Everett and Wayward Lad, and behind Wayward Lad is Drumlagan, and then comes Royal Bond. Mistake by Wayward Lad at that one. He's third from last. They're racing to the top of the hill. Brown Chamberlain's in the lead from Bragorn in second. And then comes $50 more and Observe and Foxborough and Burrahill Lad, and then Scott Lane and Canny Danny and Everett and Wayward Lad, and then Drumlagan and Royal Bond as they run down towards the next. The ninth of the 22 fences in all. Brown Chamberlain in the lead from Bragorn and $50 more. Then Observe on the inside of Burrahill Lad. Then comes Foxborough. Then Scott Lane and Canny Danny. Then Wayward Lad towards the outside. Then Everett. Then Drumlagan and Royal Bond as they come down to the 10th. Brown Chamberlain, Bragorn. From $50 more and Burrahill Lad and Wayward Lad and Observe, then Scott Lane and Foxborough, then Canny Danny and Everett, Drumlagan and Royal Bond. This will be the second last fence on the next circuit. It's number 11 of the 22 this time, and Brown Chamberlain's in the lead from Bragorn. $50 more is next. Then Burrahill Lad and Wayward Lad and Observe and Scott Lane are behind them, Canny Danny, and then Everett. Then Royal Bond improving a little, Drumlagan and Foxborough is now the back marker. Brown Chamberlain lands in the lead from Bragorn, little between the two, $50 more is next. Then Wayward Lad, Burrahill Lad, Observe, Canny Danny, Scott Lane, Royal Bond, Everett and Drumlagan. Now quite a long run to the next fence. A plain one before the water, and still John Frankham on Brown Chamberlain making the running in the 1984 Girl Cup. From Bragorn on the inside, $50 more, and Wayward Lad and Burrahill Lad and Observe come next, and then Scott Lane, and as they come to the 13th, Royal Bond improving a little on the outside. Brown Chamberlain lands in the lead there, $50 more, a bad mistake, gets away with it. Bragorn has lost a lot of ground there and looks as though he's pulling up with Graham Bradley. Is under pressure, losing a lot of ground. Brown Chamberlain landed in the lead there from Burrahill Lad making ground on the inner, and Bragorn has now gone back into the picture. Wayward Lad is improving on the outside. Scott Lane's only just in behind him, and then comes Royal Bond as they jump the third ditch, and Brown Chamberlain landed in the lead there from Burrahill Lad and Bragorn, and Wayward Lad on the outside. Bragorn once again losing ground and under pressure, but losing a lot of ground as they jump that one. Beginning to swing left-handed now and face towards the final ditch. Everett is tailed off last. This is six from home. Brown Chamberlain's in the lead from Burrahill Lad and Wayward Lad. Just in behind them comes Scott Lane, Drumlagan, who's improving. The final ditch. Brown Chamberlain lands in the lead from Burrahill Lad, Wayward Lad, Scott Lane, Drumlagan, racing towards the top of the hill now. Five from home, Brown Chamberlain in the lead from Borough Hill Laird. Wayward Laird, Scott Lane and Drumlargan. Drumlargan still improving. Canny Danny comes next. Racing downhill now towards the fourth from home. Brown Chamberlain in the lead from Borough Hill Laird second. Scott Lane has gone third. Drumlargan is still improving with every stride. Wayward Laird comes next, and then comes Canny Danny improving from the rear. Brown Chamberlain down in the lead there from Borough Hill Laird. Then came Scott Lane. Mistake by Wayward Laird at that one. They're coming down now towards the third last, and it's Brown Chamberlain from Borough Hill Laird. Drumlargan is still coming there. Then comes Scott Lane and Canny Danny over the third last. Brown Chamberlain, Borough Hill Laird, Drumlargan a mistake. Then comes Scott Lane and Canny Danny racing towards the second last fence now, and the elbow with Brown Chamberlain in the lead from Borough Hill Laird, Drumlargan, Scott Lane and Canny Danny. Just two fences left to jump in the Gold Cup. Brown Chamberlain in the lead from Borough Hill Laird coming to challenge. It's John Frankham from Phil Tuck. There's little between the two at the second last. Drumlargan is third. Scott Lane four. Brown Chamberlain and Borough Hill Laird together. Brown Chamberlain jumps out to the right a little bit. It's Brown Chamberlain on the near side. Borough Hill Laird on the far side. There's nothing between them. John Frankham and Phil Tuck at the final fence. Borough Hill Laird lands in the lead on the far side. It's Borough Hill Laird on the far side. Brown Chamberlain on the near side. Drumlargan is third. They're racing into the closing stages. Borough Hill Laird on the far side. Brown Chamberlain getting a great sprint out of the rails on the near side. But Borough Hill Laird's going to hold him and win the Gold Cup. Borough Hill Laird's the winner. Brown Chamberlain is second. Drumlargan is third. That's the 1-2-3. Scott Lane is just fourth ahead of Bregorn, $50 more, and Canny Danny, and then came Royal Bond and Observed. And so the result of the 1984 Tote Cheltenham Gold Cup, first number four, Borough Hill Laird, owned by Mr. Stan Riley, trained by Mrs. Jenny Pittman, the first lady to train the winner of this historic steeplechase classic, ridden by Phil Tuck. Second was number three, Brown Chamberlain, owned by Mrs. Basil Samuel, trained by Fred Winter, ridden by John Frankham. And third was number six, Drumlargan, owned by Mr. Michael Cuddy, trained by Eddie O'Grady, and ridden by Mr. Frank Cord. And fourth was number 11, Scott Lane. And here is the hero of the 1984 Gold Cup, Borough Hill Laird, owned by 59-year-old Stan Riley, who bred him and named him after the village where he was born, and getting a tremendous reception. And here's how he won it, as we review it with Richard Pittman.
And it had been a fairly good pace. They'd spread them out early on, and Wayward Laird, the favourite, never jumping at all, made a lot of mistakes. As they come to the second last, Borough Hill Laird on the inside of Brown Chamberlain, who runs across right-handed from here. Drumlargan, the only other one in contention. But Brown Chamberlain running a long way off a straight line. Phil Tuck, he must be feeling marvellous at this point. He'd lost the ride for three times. John Frankham, who's nearest to us riding Brown Chamberlain, had ridden this horse to his last three wins, and now going to the last, just a good jump will clinch it. John Frankham asks and gets a good one from Brown Chamberlain, but he again runs across right-handed, and here on in, Phil Tuck riding this Jenny Pittman trained gelding powers up the hill. This young rider, who had his face bent for him only about 3 weeks ago, how he must be feeling now, with just the jam stick only 100 yards away from him and the Cheltenham Gold Cup. There aren't too many riders who've won this race in their time, and for Phil, it's a great triumph. Brown Chamberlain running on in second place, but he lost a little bit of ground, but he was fairly and squarely beaten by Borough Hill Laird.
So it's a nap hand, five triumphs in a row for this immensely improved 8-year-old by Rich Boy out of Green Monkey by Port Harvey. And the distance is 3 lengths and 8 lengths. And what a fantastic comeback for Phil Tuck, this and this horse that he rode early on in his career, at which time it was certainly difficult to envisage him ending up Borough Hill Laird in the coveted winner's circle after steeplechasing's great classic, the 57th running of this now Tote-sponsored Cheltenham Gold Cup, worth £35,373 to the winner. So another resounding training triumph for Jenny Pittman. We 1983 national with Corbière, and now the 1984 Tote Challenge.